We've got more F1 World action for you today. Welcome along, everybody, as we look down at our grid. Who's your driver to follow? With good opportunities to overtake at the end of the Wellington and Hanger Straits, there's a lot of potential for close action around the 3.6 miles of Silverstone Circuit. With 18 corners and average lap speeds of around 145 miles per hour, it's also one of the longest and quickest circuits on the calendar. Some really technical terms coming up for our drivers today. Maggots, Becketts, Chapel, making that unforgettable triple header. And of course, then there's the high-speed cops. The first battle is keeping it together on the track. And there are positions to be gained and made here. Anthony Davidson's with me today. Imagine for one moment that your car is slower than the opposition's. Can you still be competitive?
Well, I always liked having a car where you could really knuckle down and try and do things in that piece of equipment that people weren't expecting. And I think that's the part that you have to look at and use that as a positive thing. People aren't expecting you to perform, so now's the chance to get out there and raise a few eyebrows.
Okay, how was that pull away? You'll have a bit more grip than that on the start, but we need to warm the tyres properly now. Make sure you get some heat into the brakes as well. Radar is clear, weather is looking good for now. Superb parking there, mate. Let's make sure we get the edge on the surrounding drivers as the lights go out. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid is formed. Be ready with the clutch. Thank you. enabled. Okay, well done. That's three clean laps in a row. Beautiful stuff. Keep it going. Done on keeping it nice and clean out there. Good stuff. You know what they say? Consistency's half the battle, isn't it? go, go! That stop was slower than we ideally wanted to see. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go. That's just 5 laps of fuel remaining. Amazing stuff, the win, and it was super clean. That was a joy to watch.
Plenty of action here at Silverstone, a memorable race and an impressive victory. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
Well, what a thrilling end to an incredible Grand Prix weekend. Our top three finishers should be incredibly happy with what they were able to achieve out there today. It's not where you start, it's where you finish. So even though it might have been a disappointing start to the season for some, plenty of time to rise through the rankings as we continue in F1 World.